All right, team, so welcome everyone. My name is Cory Dooley with the Renaissance Club Sport. Welcome Formula 3, welcome Club Sport members. It is 9 o'clock and this is Strong for Wednesday. So you will need your dumbbells today. You will need a bench or you can use the couch, a cooler, something that you'll be able to lay from your hips, top of your hips up, laying your full body on it. And yes, you can do the couch. I've showed that before. Bubba's on my couch, but I've actually brought my flat bench that turns into an incline bench from downstairs. I brought that up. Also, one thing I forgot, if you don't have an extra set of weights that you can actually lean on with your heels, so we're going to do some goblet squats. So I'm going to take these other ones and see how I press my heels on them. So we're going to be doing that just to hit the quads a little bit more. What also works great if you don't have an extra set of weights is two books or some book, but you want it about 1 to 2 inches off the floor, okay? So that's the equipment we'll need. Just a try attitude. I will mute everybody. Hopefully I'll notice. My eyes every day, gang, are getting worse because I'm wearing my glasses so much. And I used to be able to see, you know, flies getting it on over there on the side of the wall. Not that I wanted to see that. Just kidding. All right, so let's get started. Pace yourself. Respect yourself. Anytime that you need to step off to the side or you need to take a break, I'm completely okay with that. I will tell you this. This is going to be a lot of legs. So if you did a lot of legs yesterday, you may want to modify. I'll give progressions and modifications. You can do the legs without weights. That's always welcome. But yeah, it's going to be a lot of legs. That's okay. We didn't do a lot of legs on Monday, right? All right, guys, so we're going to start off with our feet nice and wide. Hope you guys like a little bit of rock. All right, how is my voice talking with the music? Is it good? Carolyn, okay, thank you. See, the more people we get, now you guys are back into that little square again. And the music volume is good? That's why sometimes, though, they can't get these on YouTube because I'm blocked with the music. All right, Sharon, we're good to go. Let's take the feet nice and wide, okay? Your chest is lifted. Just give me big shoulder rolls. Turn those shoulder rolls into big arm circles. Oh, pushing that chest forward. Using the breath, inhale and exhale as the arms go back. Reverse the circles. Take it forward. Oh, that feels good. Now, if you did my class on Monday, we did a lot of shoulders. So I have a routine. If you're just joining me, this today will be a little bit of chest and a lot of legs. Take your hands on your hips. Give me a little bit of attitude. Shake the booty. Come on. Let me see it, guys. Oh, just kidding. I just want to see if you guys could do it. Let's shift to the right and to the left. You guys, some of you haven't woken up, right, John? So now, as you're shifting, your toes are facing straight forward. You're putting your weight into your butt cheeks. Good morning, Margie. Did you mute yourself? Side to side. There we go. I'll help you. Keep going, guys. I'll mute you, Margie. I wish we were halfway there. There we go. Can you hear me now? So remember, guys, if you can't hear me for some reason, you also have volumes on your computers. Yes? All right. Side to side. Right, left, right, left. Ooh. Let's lift up that right knee and hold it. Lift and hold. Step it back out. Lift and hold. Step it back out. Keep going. Somebody's giving me a message. Somebody's going to go. Oh, you guys don't hear the music? Oh, well, I was jamming. It was good for me. Video, hyper, hyper, share music, advance, share. All Do you hear it now? No. Well, son of a gun. Thank you, Rosie. Let's do this one more time. Output. Now, do you hear it? There we go. Yay! Well, shoot, do you know what then? I gotta start this over. Don't worry, warm up on when we start it over. Here we go again. Well, I was jamming to myself. Is that good? Volume's good? I can see you. Thank you. What do you play when you say some, play some rock and roll music? All right, full screen. Hi, Jody. All right, that is down. All right, guys, so bring the feet back together. We're going to step back with that right leg. Take the arms up and overhead. Stay with that right leg. Straight back. Open the chest. Reach to the ceiling. The arms can go wide. I just want you to feel that chest. Press towards the camera. Hi, everybody. I want you to feel your quadricep. Drive your hips forward too, right here. Push that knee towards the floor. I had to play the whole class with just me listening to the music. All I could see was two more. Yes. Now, on the next one, you're going to take that leg forward. Same right leg. Take it forward. Come straight back up. Take it forward again. So just a front lunge. Take it forward. Good. Push off. Should be feeling the quadricep warming up. Shoulders again are relaxed. Let's take the arms. Reach them forward. Open them wide. Forward. So this is just telling you how your body feels today. Four more. Yes. Three. Two. And last one. We're going to switch to that left leg. Going behind. Rear lunge. Open it up. Open it up. Good. Big exhale. Inhale. Yeah, body temperature heating up in here. So yesterday, I didn't get back with some of you guys. What a day. My one dog over here had a cancer appointment, like a follow-up. So as we're getting ready to take her, the Dane in the back here, stomach, started to distend and he was crying like he was bloating. Take that leg forward. So we get to load him in the truck and he is in pain. And I'm like, oh my God, no. So one of us took him to the vet over here to make sure his stomach wasn't twisting. And then she went to the other facility. Both are fine. A little stressful though. Four more. So now that I think they're all a little stressed too, they just want to rest. Last one. Perfect. All right, guys, so we're going to walk out into a plank. I just want you to give me a big inhale first. Forward fold. Bend your knees when you need to. Down to the floor. Walk the right hand. Walk the left. Walk the right. Walk the left. Knees down. Or leave your knees up. We're warming up. Push up. Here we go. Inhale, down, hold. Exhale, push up. Inhale, down, hold. Exhale, push up. Yes. Inhale, down. Exhale, push up. Five more. Your abs are nice and tight. You're noticing your chest is warming up. Down and hold. Oh yeah, and push up, down and hold, exhale, push up, two more, out of love, push it up, last one, inhale down, hang out down there, and push up, give me a little child's pose to where you push your hips back towards your heels, extend your arms straight out in front of you, ooh, that feels good, all right. So we are nice and warm. We are so glad we get to work out today. I want you to grab dumbbells. Start off with dumbbells. I'm going to grab some 15s, but you'll probably see me switch to 10s and then to 5s. So this is going to be timed. I want you to take your time, okay? I'll go side so you can see it. Your right leg is going to go 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, straight up, okay? We're staying with the right leg only. I'll show you from the back side. So right leg, okay, is going to go 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, and straight back up. You can add a knee lift if you ate your Wheaties this morning, all right? Stay with that leg. Keep your shoulders stacked over the hips. Short little step. Here we go. 3, 2, right leg. 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock. How about a knee lift? 4 o'clock, 5, 6, yes. So what's working here is the opposite leg. Hamstring, quad, little inner thigh. Hello. Slow. I want you to think about how low you can get that knee down to the floor. Can I get it lower? Can I go slower? Can I resist trying to use momentum? Pure power. Woo! Yes. Now and then. Come on, team. Get me low. Yes, you can. So right away, I'm feeling fatigued. We're almost there. And then we'll switch to that other side. I see you, Margie. Oh, last one. Oh, excellent. Hello. Opposite side. Make sure that foot and hip are facing straight forward. Left side. We're going to 8, 6, and 5. Ready? 5, 6, and 8. Here we go. 4. And back. Straight up knee. 8, 7, and 6. There, we got it. Woo! Now, feel it. Can you go lower? How's that other front leg feeling? Short little step, but that knee is still going down to the floor. How about that knee lift? That deceleration. Oh! Nice and low, Jody. Good, Sharon. Shoulders are staying stacked. I like it. Keep going. Switching my weights. Woo! Nothing like some ACDC. Shoulders. Abs in tight. You got about 15 seconds. Left leg. The good news after this, your legs get a little bit of a rest. We go right into chest that we didn't work on Monday. Take it easy. Yeah. Low. Low. Lift. Last one. Excellent job. Hello. Yes or yes? Now we're warm. All right, I want you to give me a crescent lunge with one knee on the floor. Perfect opportunity. To place that pad underneath your knee. So your left knee is down. Your right leg is in front. Shoulders are stacked over the hips. A lot of weight is on the front knee heel as well, okay? Grab a little bit lighter here. So what I want you to do is you're going to take one dumbbell. You're going to come up from your hip, come across your knee that's in front. Now, you're going to feel a little bit of bicep, very little. I want you to feel it through the pectoralis right here where I have a lot and I want to tuck it back into that bra, okay? Up like a server, so your palm is facing up. Yes, Caroline, nice one, eh? And then you slowly come back down. This is still core. If you're moving, take the foot wider to give yourself a greater center of gravity. Yes or yes? All right, up quick, down slow. Shoulders stacked. 3, 2, let's go, scoop it. Down slow. So if you're feeling your bicep, I want you to think about scooping it from the chest. John, your knee that's down has the dumbbell. Is that right? I can't see you very well. But the knee that's down, which is your left, okay. Now come across that knee. Your attachment of the chest is at the sternum. So you're going in the same direction as the muscle fibers. Woo! I gotta switch to that 10. I didn't miss a beat. You know, if you guys were doing these on your own, what you would do? You'd stop and tie your shoe. You'd easily get distracted and start going like this, like Margie does a lot. Woo! Now, if you're fatiguing, it's gonna not go as high as your shoulder right now. That's what I'm looking for. Lene, push it out like you're serving me that champagne. There you go. Love it, Jody. If you have a light weight, hold it up there as long as you can and let it come down slow. You got less than 10 seconds, team. Oh, woo. One more. Beautiful, set that weight down. Keep the knee down, grab your heavier weight. We're gonna go for an undergrip dumbbell row. Mama gonna knock you out. You don't do these right. So on Monday, we did rows like this, okay? So your palm was facing in. That is back. Now you're gonna face the palm forward and you're gonna pull up. So it's a little bit different area of the back, yes? So I want you to hinge over. We're on the exact same side still. I'm gonna rest my right elbow on my right quadricep. I'm gonna keep my back nice and long, yes? Grab the weight, your palm faces forward, okay? Under grip, pull, and release behind. Pull, reach it past the toe, pull it up. Let's go, come with me, pull it up. Try to avoid rotating the shoulders. I want you to push your chest towards the floor. That flattens your back. Good, good, Sandy. Ooh! Party people! When you get that elbow as high as you can behind the back, Ann, hold it there, come on, Ange. Hold it there, Ange. Release slow, hold. Release slow. Don't worry, guys. When we get back to the gym, I know you'll go into working really fast. Not right now. We have to minimize that speed. Here we go. It's tricky. Tricky, tricky, tricky. Come on, Jen. 10 seconds. Whoop, baby. Now notice where your breath is. Notice where your heart rate is compared to where we were when we did those legs. That got me hot. Last one. Gorgeous. All right. Flip the legs. Other leg into that crescent lunge. Tricky. All right. So you're going into your scoops. That leg is anchored. Drive the hips forward. Squeeze your little butt. Abs stacked over. Upper hand, come across that knee, okay? Here we go, 3, 2, inhale, exhale, come across. Down slow. Now, is it okay if I rotate my shoulders a little bit? Yeah, but try to avoid it. Try to pull the abs in as tight as you can. I can see all of you guys were servers back in the day, right? You waited on tables? Come across your knee, guys. Now look at my elbow. It's hard from the angle, but it's staying close to my hip. Okay? Stays close to my hip. You can do these standing, but the reason I'm doing them down is because we have so many legs today. And I need those legs strong, baby. I gotta switch that. Keep going. Slow. Yes. Other shoulders drawn down. Abs are nice and tight. Yeah. Woo. Drop that camera, Ange. I want to see that angle, girl. I got to hold you accountable. Come on. I'm watching you. Last one. Beautiful. All right. Grab that heavier dumbbell. If you don't have one, yes, double up on your weight. Even if you only get 5 reps and you can't hold it anymore, then fight in one weight. But I want you to grab, start off progression. Under grip row, yes? Take your chest forward. Lean on that left leg with your left elbow. Palm is facing away from your body. Take the weight towards the toe. Push the chest out. Inhale, exhale, pull. Inhale, exhale, pull. Now, when I pull that, Carol Ann, I want you to bend your forearm just a little. So my forearm, the dumbbell's coming right below my chest. There you go. Yeah. Now, still drive that elbow to the ceiling, guys. Drive the elbow. There it is, girl. Woo, it's the headband working. Yeah, so good, Sarah. Tricky. Here we go. So think about where you're feeling this. If we really start to make that connection with mind-body, the area that we're working, yes, it helps. You will develop stronger muscles, just that awareness. It's so important. I know sometimes I like to work out and just space off. That's what I use usually my cardio for. Pull it up. Release it down. We got less than 20 seconds, Margie. So good to see you. Let me begin. Pack it in. Woohoo! I like it. Ooh. One more. Oh, good news. You're done with those two. Even better news, we're going back to legs. So get some water, my strong team. So what I want you to do, jump up, get down. I'm going to take my dumbbells, and I'm going to take them so I can place my heels on them, okay? So you're doing a heel elevated goblet squat. Can you guys see that? I'll turn the opposite way, backwards, okay? So my heels are elevated. I like to turn my toes out when I do this squat. So I'm here, okay? Straight down, straight back up. Grab those books. Grab what you need to grab. Make sure for your hips, if you're tight, what are you gonna do? Are you gonna give me a really tight goblet squat? Go wide, okay, Sandy? Yes, you? John, usually guys are tighter. Feel free to turn your toes out a little bit. Just make sure, team, that the knees are going the same direction as the toes. All right, can you grab one heavy dumbbell? I got a 25 if anybody wants to borrow it. If you don't, grab a couple. Now, you can do the same squat with dumbbells on your shoulders. I'm holding the dumbbell right here, nice and secure. There we go, Carol Ann. First thing I want you to do is go down, look at your knees. They are going in the same direction as your toes. If they're going past your toes and you have bad knees, don't go as low. Okay, I'm still down here, guys. Get your butts down. Look down. All good. Chest stays lifted. Straight back up. Yeah? All right. Slow and controlled. You should be feeling this through your quadricep. 3, 2, let's go. Drive the elbows towards the quadriceps. Drive back up. Squeeze the butt cheeks as you come up. Now, your heels are lifted, so that's placing a lot more weight on the quads. jump around. If you feel like you don't like this for whatever reason, take those out. But remember, on the other side, we're still doing them without the heels elevated. So the front of your shin, called the anterior tibialis, that is actively working right now. It's supposed to. It works in a regular squat as well. Look how slow you guys are going. Margie, can we come down here? There we go. Yes, you can. Every one of you have gotten stronger butts in the last 3 weeks. I've seen it. Woo, baby. Now actively squeeze your knees towards each other a little bit so that your knees aren't doing this. Squeeze them towards each other. Engage the inner thighs. They work out too. Yes, they do. You got 30 seconds. I'm going to breathe in and out through my nose, so I have to shut up for a second. Just slow my heart rate. I love it. Chest is always lifted, John. You have a name tag. Your Mercedes-Benz emblem. Hood ornament is showing. One more. Woo! Oh, baby! Set those off to the side. You still have your heavy dumbbell. Hydrate. Same squat. Goblet squat. Same deep range of motion. Maybe a little bit more. This time, your heels are not elevated. All right, let's go. Same thing, kids. This time, it's more glute and hamstring. Going in five. I like that side view so you guys can see the angle. My shoulder stack. Let's go. How low can you go? I want you going to where your butt is at least knee level. Okay? If you start to do this, stop. Because you're not working your glutes. You're working your lower back and everything else. So, chest stays lifted. Inhale down. Exhale, push away. Woo! How are we doing? Where's my regression? If I fatigue, or all of a sudden I can't go as low, I like it, Ange, what do? I set the weight down, and I grab a lighter one, or I do it without weight. It's up to you. Keep pushing your chest out, beautiful. Woo! You'll never walk alone. 30 seconds. Oh. We're going back to quads on the other side. Good, Jody. Hang out there, guys. Squeeze the little butt. 15 seconds. How are we doing? Yes. One more. Oh, awesome. Great job. I gotta open a window here. It's getting hot in here. Before I take off all of my clothes and scare you guys off, I'll open a window. All right, here's what's happening. You're gonna walk around your house, or you stay where you're at and do a static lunge, okay? Here's the difference with the lunge. Okay? Not this short little step. See the difference? This is no more than 2 feet between my legs. Why? It's quadricep, okay? If I take a big long lunge and my heel comes up, that's hamstring and glute. We just worked hamstring and glute. So, short little step, down and up. Shoulders stay stacked. If I lean forward, automatically goes in the butt. Save that butt, you're gonna need it. Now, if you wanna walk around, walk around. if you want to stay static, you're going to keep that one leg in front, and I'll tell you when to switch. Yes or yes? Perfect. Ah! So I'm going to take my left leg forward. I want one, two little steps behind. Now, this for some of you will limit the range. I can go all the way down, but I don't have tight quads. I've been doing my sip and stretch. There's a plug. You can keep your arms down here. You can have no weight. It's up to you. So I'm going to go static because I know some of you guys don't have a lot of room. Angie, please drop your camera so I can see your legs, beautiful girl. Three, two, and one. Straight up, straight down. Woo! Now your front leg can unload a little bit, but not a lot. You're gonna notice my range of motion's gonna shorten pretty quick. As it starts to shorten, I'm probably gonna drop one weight, and then I'm gonna drop another weight. Now, will you feel these in your quads? Yes. Will you feel these in your hamstring and butt? Yeah, if you've been overtraining them, they're gonna fatigue too. Now, I want you to notice, if you feel like your center of gravity's off, take the foot wider, okay? So like this, take it wider versus right here. You should be able to see that foot if it's in the mirror. Keep going, 30 seconds. Woohoo! I know. See, we could do home workouts. Here's the good thing about this. We can build muscle, but we don't necessarily bulk when we don't have heavier weights. Less than 5 seconds. Excuse me. Perfect. Ah. Woohoo. Do we feel those? Thumbs up. Any birds? Nobody wants to flip me off today. I get, thank you, Margie. Thank you so much. We're gonna switch to the other side. Again, take your foot right behind the other one. See how my feet are length stacked? I'm gonna take it one more back. There's my lunge, right? We're going in 10. Shoulders stay stacked. I'll turn sideways a little. Three, two, and one. Down and up. Yeah, there you go, John. So notice you're not leaning forward. You have to lean forward. But if you're feeling that knee, you're probably tight through your quad that's pulling on the kneecap. Bad knees may hurt with arthritis, but as you start to feel better through the day, you know that's arthritis, right? If it continues to hurt through the day, but you've stretched, you've rolled, then that last resort, you might have bad knees, I don't know. But you gotta take care of the other factors first. It's called process of elimination. And if you don't think your doctor does that, ask him. What did he do first? He asks you questions. What does he do next? Most of them send you home. Maybe an x-ray. Maybe an MRI. 30 seconds, you guys are looking good. There goes my weight. Woohoo! Remember, no judgments. All you're able to do is what your mind or your last recovery allows. We got this. Less than 15. Just keep moving. Oh, is that Hank? I saw you. I'm watching you. Three, two, oh. Is this kicking your butt? Because if it's not, guys, then I am really out of shape. Please tell me it is. I thought it was just me, Ange. All right, get your cooler, get your couch. I got a great bench for you guys. So you're gonna grab a dumbbell. Try a heavier one first. I'm gonna set the dumbbell behind the couch a couple feet, okay? Let me turn this music down so you can hear me clear. Now, on my bench, if you're on the couch, you're gonna hang over the armchair. You're here like this, okay? So right at my hip, where I bend at my hip goes right on the cooler, the couch, the bench, whatever you have. So I'm gonna have to push that weight back just a little. It takes a little bit of work through your feet to hold the dumbbell. This is called hamstring curls. You guys do these at the club, yes? Works the same exact way. So I'm gonna reach out in front. I'm gonna take the weight, grab it with my feet, okay? And I'm just gonna curl up. Don't be laughing, Margie. Grab that weight. I'm not very good with my feet today. All right, and I'm curling up, and then I go back down. Curl up and back down. Now, you don't have a bench. Guess what? You can do these on the floor. I'll show you on the floor, Jody. So the weight goes upright. My feet, I'll go this way, so you guys can see the backside. I'm on my belly, my feet, grab the weight. Okay, see how I grabbed it? I squeeze them together, I lie down, I tap the floor slowly, and I come back up. Down slow, come back up. Guys, don't swing it. That weight will come and hit you right in the bum. Tap the floor every time, straight overhead. You don't have to come all the way up to your heel, your butt. The reason is, like you do in the gym, you're not getting extension here. The muscle's already relaxed because you're on the floor. If you're on the bench, Carol Ann, you will lift up as high as you can, but try to avoid moving your knees, okay? Are we ready? Here we go, Sarah. Lie on that floor. Let's go, Angie. I know you're looking at my butt. Let's go. Up, down slow, slow, slow. Up, down slow, slow. Squeeze the toes together. Knees are slightly apart. Woo! See, we got the hamstrings. Oh, now, if they start to fatigue, switch to a lighter weight. Remember, your toes are squeezed together, your heels are squeezed together, right in the center of the foot, the arch, is where you're working, squeezing that dumbbell. Slow on the down. Try to focus on your non-dominant side. So if you are dominant on the right side, I really want you squeezing that left hamstring. This is the back of the leg. It runs up and makes an ass of itself. Had to throw that one in there. Come on. Yes, you got it. Your head is relaxed or to the side. Squeeze your abdominals in nice and tight. You are not pressing your hips or your belly into the floor. Okay, keep your butt from elevating. You want to avoid the butt going to the ceiling. Do not allow it to go to the ceiling. So the hips are lightly touching the floor. But you're not doing this, okay? None of that. No lifting. No twerking in here. We got 30 seconds, a little less. Woo! If you are not feeling these, you DM me because I'm going to give you a special video to show you. I did these yesterday practicing. Yeah, see, I spend my Tuesdays to figure out things for you on Wednesday. Oh, and the couch is great. I'll tell you what, or an armchair if it's nice and cushy. Last one, beautiful. Because it gives you the support through your pelvis and you got that nice rounded. Oh, good job, guys. How'd we do? Yes, we got new things. I love creating new things. All right, so we're going back to the scoops. Chest, are we good? All right, don't be so happy. I'm happy, are you happy? If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, show everybody who goes it. All right. Left knee is down. Left heel is down. I'm watching you. Let's go. Scoop it. Ready? 3, 2, let's go. Up, down, slow. Yeah. Woohoo. Up, down, slow, slow, slow. Now, for some reason, guys, you can't come to my class on Friday at 12 o'clock, the strong. I want you to do this class again, but do more reps. So if you're only getting one rep, then you can go and work this in the next day or so. The other thing is, too, if you have lighter weights, you're not taking that muscle to failure. So yes, then you can work it again, or you can stay on after class. I'm going to make you all do detention and come in here and do another round of this. Well, we could just do it. See? Why not? Right, John? Right, Sandy? Woo! 10 seconds. Slow on the down. So notice where you're feeling this. Come across that front knee. Back to the hip. Exhale. This is still working your core. Everything I do with your functional movements, guys, always works the core. So if you feel like you need extra core, start it where? In the kitchen. That's where it starts. Yes. Cut out sugars a little at a time. Last one. Beautiful. Grab a heavier weight. We have that under grip row. Say move. Say, mama gonna knock you out. All right, hinge forward. Right elbow goes on the right quadricep. I'm long through my spine. Keep my chest pushed to the floor. Shoulders are even to the floor. Under grip, and let's go. Pull it up, down slow. Reach it forward, pull the elbow behind you. Inhale, exhale. Shuffling. Yes. Woo! Nothing is sexier than a strong back. I'm liking it. Good. Now, if you start to fatigue, you're going to notice your shoulders are going to round forward. You're going to start to feel your back because you're releasing your abdominals. So again, if you have a mirror, look in that mirror, your beautiful self. Notice the form. And then close your eyes and feel the form. Feel the muscle, connect that awareness. This is part of your mid-back, your lat. 15 seconds. Woo, party rockers. Can you feel it? One more. Awesome, so good. Every day I'm shuffling. All right, switch sides. Got my line up here. Once again, if I feel like this is a lot, like I'm a little unsturdy today, my balance is off, take your foot wider, okay? But I want your shoulders stacked. Weight starts off at the hip, palm facing, away from your body, shoulders back and down. Inhale, exhale, let's go. Cross that knee, down slow. A little bit of bicep, a little bit of shoulder is helping with the chest. Woo. Every day I'm shuffling. Yeah, so with my Dane yesterday, we used to have two other Danes like 20 years ago. And my one, his stomach twisted. So he was 7. And that is why most Danes die at 7 years old. So we came back from a walk slow walk. He acted the same exact way, his stomach's distorted. But my Dane 20 years ago, within 30 minutes, we had him on the table and I got to go in on the surgery. That's when I was wanting to be a vet. And opened him up and he lived till he was 13. The thing about Bubba back here is we sutured his stomach to his sidewall, but it still can happen in rare cases. Now, see, doesn't that help if I tell you stories to forget about your chest? Yeah, it does. All right, go to that undergrip row. Last set of these, kids. We're doing good on time. Left elbow on the quadricep, hinge forward. I want the weight. Palm facing away, going past your toe, and then I want that elbow going behind. So I want you to avoid. Look at my forearm right here. I don't want that. That places too much on your wrist and your forearm. So keep your elbow right here, your forearm right there. So the wrist is still in front of the elbow, so you're not feeling the placement on your elbow, okay? Keep that in mind. Here we go. Inhale, exhale. Drive it up. Chest pushes to the floor. I'm squeezing my Kegels. That starts the abdominal work. I'm inhaling and I'm exhaling as I bring it up as high as I can. Now I'm pulling my lats into my back pocket. I'm pulling my traps down. They're working a little, but not a lot. So Lene, make sure, see how my hand, my dumbbell is not going past my hip, only my elbow is going higher to the ceiling. There you go. So look at your wrist in alignment with your elbow. It should be in front. There's where that mirror comes into play. Yes. Woo! I like it, guys. Come on, Ange. Nice, Hank. Good. Pull up. If I'm not calling some of you guys out, it's because I can't see in your room. The lighting. I still love all of you. Pull it up. 15 seconds. Woo! We got this. You guys going to join me for sip and stretch today? It's going to be a good leg. We'll get your lats and the chest. It's at 5:30. Woo! Last one. Awesome. All right. As we head back in, we are going to finish with the heels elevated goblet squat, the regular goblet squat, the short static or walking quadricep lunges, and the cooler with or the floor with the hamstrings. Yes or yes? Woo! Shake it. So, goblet squat. I have a 30. Do you? Come on. You can do it. Set up those weights or books. Keep them apart. Place the heels on them before you grab your weight, okay? Make sure you can turn your toes out a little bit. One thing that's always important when you squat, you want your feet even, okay? So if I'm squatting here and one foot is in front of the other, when I squat, it's gonna tweak my back. So feet are even, in alignment. I'm gonna turn my toes out. Ooh. Quadriceps, let's go. Down, squeeze up. Push the hips back still. Squeeze up. Woo! Now, if I'm only going right here, then I want you to set the weight down and build the muscle without using the weight, because if I can't get range of motion, that's not gonna be good for you. Okay, work on range and then give me the weight. And then what comes next? Speed or slowing it down. Yeah, Kathleen. Woo! Chest is lifted, team. I think I got strong at this at a young age because I lived on a farm. And when you had to go to the bathroom, you wanted to get low, but not so low that you hit the poison ivy. Woo! Yes! 15 seconds. Is your chest still lifted? Are you pulling your abs in? Yeah. Last one. Beautiful. Move those. Same thing. Last goblet squat. Let me get some water. Thank you. Thank you for staying with me, for working out with me, for inviting others, for reaching out, doing this together as a team. All right, look at those feet. Let's go. This time, hamstring and butt. Come on, Rosie. If you guys weren't here, I would have set that weight down a long time ago. So you're placing that stress on me to keep going, just like I am you. Because we all get to that point where we want to stop. We want to just go, forget it. Somebody else can push you through it. If I'm in your head. Woo! Oh, less than 45 seconds. You got it. Come on, Margie. Hey, here's the good news. No goblet squats on Friday. Thank God. 15 seconds. Where's Bajan, Carol Ann? I want to see him. You get his little butt in here. One more. Excellent. Set that big boy down. Whew. Heart is racing. That's a good thing. There's your cardio. All right, so we are going into either walking lunges or a static lunge. Yes or yes? You're almost there. Doesn't matter what, legs forward, hold it forward. Short little step. Let's go. Down and up. Now, I can lean forward, but that's gonna be butt. Rosie, shoulders stay stacked. Do not lean forward. Straight up and down. Straight up and down. I just dropped my weight, and I'm going even deeper. Yes. Are your glutes feeling it? Yeah, you just did goblet squats. Keep that front knee right over the ankle. 15 seconds. Ah. I love legs today. Last one. Switch legs. I need a massage. 3, 2, short little step if you're walking, keep going. Let's go. So if you're noticing you're fatigued, good. That means you crush this workout. If you're like, who is that instructor? That was so easy. You know what that tells others? I'll leave it up to your imagination. You're your best coach. Woo, 30 seconds. Short, up and down. Shoulder stacked, knee over. Holy goodness. I think I'm going to cancel cycle tomorrow. Actually, honestly, it helps me from being too sore. Any kind of movement tomorrow, guys, same for you. Walk. If you're sore and you do nothing, you're going to be worse Friday. You're going to be hating life. 10 seconds. Movement, delayed onset muscle soreness, dumbs. You want blood flow. Otherwise, it gets worse after 2 days. Last one. Rock you. Ah. All right, we got the hamstring curls. We got to do them. Yes, we do. Your bench, your cooler. Let's get it. The floor. If you felt that dumbbell, good. If you didn't, you either do more reps or you grab a heavier dumbbell. Now this feels good right here, just to lie here. I'll see you. Last one, team, everybody. 3, 2, let's go. Tap the floor, lift back up. And that 15 right away just fatigued the crap out of my hammies. If you cramp, good luck with that. Get some electrolytes. I got a perfect recommendation if you don't know of any good ones. Hold that weight tight. We will rock you. Show me, guys. Come on. We got this. Don't make those faces. That's it. Remember, if you're coming up, as soon as it's your heels are above your butt, you stop and go back down. Keep the butt from elevating. Wow, you guys are awesome. So good. Woo! We will rock you. 10 seconds. I love it. Oh yeah. 3, 2, and 1. Excellent job. All right. Fog it up. I gotta go to some nice, beautiful, cool down music. Here we go. Ah, oh, I hope you guys feel good. As good as you look, because you are looking good. All right, let's move your equipment out of the way. Put a towel down on that sweaty self. And I want you to lie on your back. Oh. And just hug your knees as you roll back. Oh, that feels good. So I want you to take one leg, grab it behind the hamstring, behind the calf. Opposite leg can go long on the floor and just pull that leg towards you. This is hamstring. Pull it in tight. Your head's relaxed. Your back is relaxed. The doggies come around and start giving you kisses. I love it. Mommy's on the floor. Daddy's on the floor. Woohoo! Excellent work today, guys. So good. I can already tell you, on Friday, we're going to be doing inner, outer thigh a little bit. We'll hit some triceps. We'll hit some biceps. But we're going to include things that all functional movements that work together. Good. Now take that knee, bend it in. Take the leg across your body. Your arms can be in a T. You can leave your shoulders down or you can come up. Gentle, whatever feels best for your body. If you can keep your shoulders down, great. Just feel that stretch through your lower back. Take a nice deep inhale through the nose. And then exhale even slower. So if you're breathing in for 5 seconds, I want you to exhale for 8 to 10. As you feel stressed throughout the day, practice that breathing technique. Practice the progressive relaxation. The tightening of every muscle in your body for 10 seconds, as tight as you can get it, and then release it. That has been shown to work throughout the body for up to 8 hours after you do that. It is such a great tool. I learned that back when I was, how long ago was my freshman year in college? Yeah, it wasn't that long ago. Maybe like 10 years ago. Come back up center, other way. Working for that exercise physiology degree. All right, so grab behind the calf, pull that leg in, opposite side. Again, everybody's different, but your knee is bent, and that is stretching the hamstring. Notice if it's a little tight, you want to give it some extra love. Shoulders are relaxed down. Find that breath again. My legs are shaking. I don't know if you guys see that. Oh, boy. Good. And release. Take that knee across the body. Gentle. You want to lift the shoulder up. If you want to slight turn through the upper body that direction, it's okay. Just notice that the heart rate's come down, the breath is back to comfortable. Help both knees come back to center. Hug your knees, just roll side to side and forward and back, and then pull yourselves up. And I want to do a quadricep. So I want you to flip over into that runner's lunge. And as you're in that runner's lunge, whatever knee is down, you take a towel or you just reach behind with whatever hand, squeeze the butt cheek, okay? And then pull the heel as close as to the butt as you can get it. Now, if I'm pushing my hips forward, I'm going to feel that a little lower down on the quadricep around the knee. If I come up and I tuck my hips and I still pull up, then I'm going to feel it a different area. So just play with that. Both are okay. And just hold it. So remember, if you know somebody, reach out and invite them to the page. That's what this is about, keeping people moving, keeping them from being depressed, or keeping them away from the refrigerator. I saw this video yesterday of drawing a blank on his name. Jason Derulo made a burger, I kid you not, that was like this big, and he made Krispy Kreme donuts for the bread. And I was like, okay, that would give me diarrhea all day long in the bathroom. Okay, guys, I want you to take that other leg forward, and now release that leg, but just push your hip forward and then open the chest. This is hip flexor. Again, squeeze your butt. You guys would be proud of me. I haven't even had ice cream. I'm proud of me. It's kind of a mindset, right? You know when you can do it. And you set up and go, you know what? Yeah, I got this. And the times that you're tempted, either take a walk, or you just reason with it and go, yeah, that's really just not worth that. I'm going to have to do this extra and switch legs, guys. So opposite leg goes forward. Keep that leg there. Squeeze the butt cheek. Pull that other leg behind. Lift it up. It's all about positivity, right? If it starts with us, That's what you can control. I always learned at a young age it could always be worse. So I'm thankful. Thankful I get to work out. Thankful you guys are joining me.
I'm thankful it's hump day.
And release that leg. Hinge forward. So all my weight's in my front heel. I'm squeezing my butt cheek and ooh, baby, I feel that. Now, if it's too much, you just lean forward. But the more you can bring your chest back and really drive your hip forward, and then you got to squeeze that little butt cheek. So if you're feeling your back, remember your butt, that's all connected. Come to the sip and stretch if you don't have time. Go back and watch an old sip and stretch to where I stretch your hamstrings, your butt, with a ball. That is so important, guys. Get out of that position. Come all the way up. And I want you to interlock your fingertips behind your back. Inhale, exhale, lift up as you lift the arms behind you. At the same time, you're pushing your chest out. My Dane is dreaming back here. He's running in the park. And release down. Give me a big inhale. Reach it up to the sky. Bring the hands together. Bring them down to the heart center. Give yourselves a great big hug, team. You were so awesome today. I will unmute all of you guys. Thank you so much, guys. Awesome work today.
Thank you, Cory. That was great.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Anne.
I'm sweating.
Okay, I see. I know. Margie, you're sweating. Let me see.
I don't see Margie.
Margie?
Margie.
There she is. Margie, talk. She's already off. She was sweating. There she is. Margie.
I'm here.
Margie, Sharon wants to see you. Look at Margie, you did this. You looked around the corner.
I see you. Hi, Margie.
Corner.
Hi.
Zooming.
Hi.
I do that too. I come up here to see what you guys are wearing down below. What are you doing? I love this one when you guys get really close to the camera. Especially early morning, testing out your camera skills. You guys.